I think we all collectively expected Leeds to come out in the second half, didn't we, and create some sort of magic and test them a little bit more. But they didn't, and credit to them for holding on.
Yeah, no shots on target for either team. But I think you have to give a lot of credit to Aston Villa and how they defended. He's right, they started really bright in the first half, got the early goal, and then it was just about a defensive performance from Aston Villa. And they had a game plan, they stuck to it, and they delivered and nullified Leeds superbly.
I don't think we expected a 1-0 scoreline at the end of this, did we, to Aston Villa?
No, when we spoke about Leeds before the game, we mentioned excitement, pressing, goals, creative. There was none of that. None of
that
at all. Well, the reason was because of Aston Villa, how they went about their job. They said it in the interview there. Straight from the off, they went after Leeds. They had a game plan. They kicked it long, as Karen highlighted it at half-time. They then played 1 and 2 touch football in the final third. And they never give Leeds a chance to settle. They never give Leeds a chance to get in the game. And Leeds were very flat, low on energy, which was surprising. But you have to say well done to Aston Villa tonight, because we said at half-time they did a job on them in the first 45 minutes. We expected so much more from Leeds in the second half. That never came again. That was all because of the way Aston Villa set up and the way they went about their job.
And, Alan, the goal came early on, within 5 minutes. How good was this goal?
It was a very good goal, yeah. Decent ball in, but they get... What they do is that they keep the ball alive, and you can see how quick and determined that they are to get that ball and keep it alive and keep it in the box. And it's a good ball in, but it's an even better touch from El Ghazi. The touch, he's off balance. He manages to get back, steady himself, and tuck it away really, really nicely. He's not offside. He perhaps thinks he is with the reaction, or he's certainly not sure. And he's looking across to the assistants for some sort of confirmation. He wasn't sure, but VAR confirmed it, and that proved to be the difference. And without a doubt, Aston Villa deserved that, because not only were they a better team going forward, they actually defended so well as a team.
Yeah, pretty much what you just said as well. Defensively, they were much better as well, and a marked improvement from the result last weekend against Leicester.
Well, I think the manager, Dean Smith, he came out and criticised them. He changed it up, a bit more fresh legs in the midfield area, and they completely dominated it there. But I think you speak about Jack Grealish not necessarily being in the Aston Villa team. I think it's about Leeds not having Calvin Phillips. Just can't seem to grind out a result. I think 1 in maybe 6 without him now. So they've got to find a way, especially in that midfield, for breaking teams down, especially if teams do what Villa did tonight.
Well, let's now hear and, of course, talk about the pitch resurfaces, no pun intended.
Yeah, and he said that was one of the reasons why they decided to go direct and play the game in the Leeds half rather than their own half. And it worked to perfection. His team was superb tonight. One chance in the second half for Rafinha, and other than that, and if you go to Elland Road and keep it down to that, the way Leeds play, they've done a good job, and they have.
Just how good a result does this one feel like today?
Yeah, amazing. Of course, the last game against Leicester we lost. We draw against Brighton. So we want to keep playing, and we want to win games. And I think it's very important for us that we win this game.
Your early goal, was that just reward for a really positive, aggressive start by Villa, do you feel?
Yeah, I think so. The gaffer told us that we have to be on it from the start, because we know that Leeds is a very good team, and they play very good, and we knew what was going to happen, so we prepared well, and a fast start it is.
Last time you played here, you'll remember, you were rather unjustly sent off. Will you leave Elland Road with better memories this time?
Yeah, I was talking with the gaffer about it yesterday, and the last time we were hit was hectic and chaotic, so I'm happy that this time a better end for me, because the last time was really disappointed. I was very upset, because I knew, you know, with the playoffs and everything, so I'm happy with the result today.
Anwar, did the players come here today with perhaps a little bit of a point to prove, what with all the talk about missing your captain, Jack Grealish?
Yeah, of course. We know Jack Grealish is a very important player for us, and we know without him it's going to be a hard game, and I think the boys did really well.
Villa's performance right from the start today was so different, in stark contrast to the performance, you mentioned it, against Leicester. What did you do so much better?
I think we pressed all together. We were on it from the start, all of us. And I think that was not against Leicester. And this week we trained, and Yeah, the gaffer told us we have to be on it from the start, and that's what we did. And you see, a positive start can be very effective.
You've worked in the past in your career with Marcelo Bielsa. You know the demands he places on his teams. Does that make this win here today that little bit more satisfying?
Yeah, of course. I will have a talk with him inside, and I have a very good relation with him. He's a very good coach, one of the best I have ever had, and I have a lot of respect for him. And unfortunately, he did not win today.
Anwar, well done today. Thank you. Dean, congratulations. Just how much credit do your players deserve for coming here and getting this result?
A lot of credit, because it's a really tough place to come. They're a very good team. Got lots of energy, lots of legs. But we matched that, and our game plan came off really well. I thought we pressed them really well in the first half. Probably made it a little bit too open at times, but second half we wanted to go with a lower block and restricted them to a few chances in the second half. It wasn't a top to be building up from at the back, because the pitch was a little bit choppy and cut up, and people were slipping, so we wanted to play safety first, and we did that today.
We talked beforehand, didn't we, about the importance of making a strong, positive start in this game. What did you think of the one you got?
Yeah, no, a really good start. I mean, we got on the front foot early. We wanted to go and play in their half. We wanted to go and pressure their build-up. And I thought we did that quite well in the first 15 minutes, and got our rewards with a goal from a corner as well. So really pleased with the start, and our intensity levels were certainly much better than they were last week.
And there is confirmation that Leeds United remain in 10th. Aston Villa, however, they secure that 8th position in the Premier League table. 39 points from their 24 games, and they are now a point away from Everton. They do have a game in hand as well, or a couple of games in hand over a couple of those teams, City and West Ham. And Leeds United, they're 10th in the table. They've lost 13 games.